Hello students, we are going to discuss about definition of moisture and other terms on drying. Important definition: moisture content, how much water present in the solid material, kg of moisture per kg of dry solid, bound moisture, amount of moisture that exert a vapor pressure less than the vapor pressure of water at the given temperature, or water cannot evaporate easily and there is pressure on such type of water. Example: hygroscopic substances. Hygroscopic is nothing but readily attract water from its surrounding. Example: honey, glycerin, ethanol, methanol, concentrated sulfuric acid and concentrated sodium hydroxide. Unbounded moisture, amount of moisture that exert a vapor pressure is equal to the vapor pressure of water at the given temperature, or water evaporate easily with a normal moisture balance, there is no pressure of such water. Example: non-hygroscopic substances. What is non-hygroscopic? Do not absorb moisture internally into the pellet. Example: polystyrene, polyethylene, polypropylene, metal powder, glass granules. Equilibrium moisture. Moisture content in a solid that can remain in equilibrium with the drying medium of a given relative humidity at a given temperature. Pre-moisture. Moisture in a wet solid in excess of equilibrium moisture. This is called pre-moisture. Only pre-moisture can be removed by drying under a given set of condition of gas. What are the conditions? Temperature and humidity. Critical moisture content. It is the moisture content when the constant rate drying period end and the falling rate drying period start. When an insoluble solid is dried, the water is lost to the surrounding air and the solid attain on equilibrium moisture content depending on the relative humidity of air. Different moisture content exhibited by a substance when exposed to air of different saturation level is shown in figure. So this figure shows that moisture content at a different humidity condition. So in this figure, X naught initial moisture content, XCR critical moisture content, X star equilibrium moisture content. In this graph, you can see X naught to X star. Refer the X naught in X axis. The corresponding relative humidity values are equal to 1. Here, the solid is dried in contact with gas. The moisture in solid exert a vapor pressure equal to the vapor pressure of pure water till a critical moisture content is reached, that is XCR. In this figure, X naught minus XCR is the unbounded moisture. Moisture decreases below XCR, the vapor pressure also decreases. Moisture in solid reaches X star, the vapor pressure in solid becomes equal to the partial pressure of water vapor in gas. X star is nothing but equilibrium moisture content. it reaches the equilibrium moisture content extra. The corresponding relative humidity also taken from the graph. XCR20 or initial condition, that is called bound moisture. X0 minus X star, that is equal to pre moisture content. X0 is the initial moisture content, X star is the equilibrium moisture content. Difference between these two, pre moisture content. Another important term used in drying, constant rate period and falling rate period. This figure shows that drying curve. This graph lags between pre moisture and drying rate. Pre moisture is nothing but kg of water to kg of dry soil. Drying rate is nothing but weight per area into tap, that is kg of water per meter square hour. First we are going to discuss about constant rate period. Refer the figure. Point B represents equilibrium temperature condition of the product surface. B to C of the curve is known as constant rate period. Represent removal of unbound water from the product. The water acts as if the solid is not present, only presence of water, and the water activity is equal to 1. Constant rate period continue as long as the amount of water evaporate is equal to the amount of water supply to the surface of the material. Are you clear or not? Okay, this is constant rate period. Second one, falling rate period. Falling rate period is reached when the drying rate start to decrease. Refer the figure. And the surface water activity falls to less than 1. Rate of drying is governed by the internal flow of liquid or vapor. This point is represented by C in the figure. This is falling rate period. At this point, the point C, is not enough water on the surface to maintain a water activity value of 1. The falling rate period can be divided into two steps. One is first falling rate period, second one second falling rate period. First falling drying rate occurs when wetted spot in the surface continually diminish, that is reducing until the surface is dried. The point number D, are you clear? Okay, C2D. This is represent first rate or first falling rate period. Second falling rate period begin at point D when the surface is completely dry. The plane of evaporation move from the surface. Heat required for moisture removal is transferred through the solid to the evaporation of moisture in the solid, and the vapor move through the solid into the air stream. Amount of water removed in this period can be relatively small compared to constant rate period and falling rate period. Why? Because in this period the water is very small compared with first falling rate and constant rate period. This period may take much longer than constant rate period. Why? Because drying is slow. So the drying is slow. So that's why it will take long time. Are you clear on? Okay, compare with constant rate period. Thank you for your attention.